Hey there, it's Lindsay, and in this video, I'm going to share with you 5 ways to record your screen using your Mac. Be sure to stay until the end so that you can enroll in my free course, Simplify Your Biz Tools, and learn about all of my other favorite tools and resources that I use for my business. Number 1, use QuickTime on your Mac for free. So you want to search for QuickTime. And then up here you go to New Screen Recording. And then hit this little down caret and you can choose your microphone and you can choose if you want to show mouse clicks in the recording. And then when you're ready, just hit the record button. And then it will tell you, you know, a few other things that you need to know. And then just do that, and then up here just hit stop, and that's it. Number 2, use Zoom. Zoom is a video conferencing tool, so you can just go up here and start a new meeting, and then choose your audio if you're going to use audio, and then if you want to use a video, you can choose that as well. And then right here in the middle, it says share screen. Click on that. And then you can choose either your desktop or a whiteboard or your iPhone via AirPlay, your iPad or iPhone via the cable, or Zoom.us. And then you can even share the computer sound where you can optimize for full screen video too. Hit share screen, do whatever you need to do to share, and then up here at the top, just hit stop share. And then since it's a video conference, you want to come down here and say end meeting. And then it will save to your computer or to the cloud, whichever one you chose. Number 3, use ScreenFlow. ScreenFlow is a paid application for your Mac, but I love it. So you come up here and you hit record, and then you configure your recording. So if you're recording from your main monitor, if you have an external monitor, if you want to have your video where your audio is, if you're using a different mic, and then if you want to record the computer audio, it really depends on how you want to set it up. And then you can come in here and set up, you know, like the size and the, you know, frame rate and all that kind of stuff. And then when you're ready, just hit the big red button and it will give you a countdown and record your screen. And then when you're done, just come up here and hit stop record. And this is a new feature with ScreenFlow 7, but it's really cool. It has this little area where it says add clip directly to timeline. So if you're recording something and you're like, oh crap, I need to go back and record something else real quick, you can add it directly to the timeline where you're working. And that's just something that's new with ScreenFlow 7. But just title it, hit okay. And then you can come in here and work on it. The reason I like using ScreenFlow is because not only can I record my screen, but I can also edit the video within the same app instead of having to use like 4 different things at the same time. Number 4, use Loom. It's a Google Chrome extension. So you come up here and you click the button, and then you can choose if you want to do your screen and the camera, if you want to do screen only, if you want to just do your camera only, your full desktop, current tab, audio, and there's a few other things that you can do as well. But when you're ready, just hit record and then just record your screen. So then down here, there are all these other things like camera settings, cancel the recording, pause, or just end the recording. So when you're done, and then what's also cool about Loom is that it puts everything on their site. So you can have your own video library inside Loom with all your videos that you've done. Or you can download it, or you can share the link for clients. It's really up to you. Number 5, use Recordit. Recordit is a small application that you'll download on your computer. And then when you're ready to use it, you just come up here and hit record. And then you can choose what area you would like to use to record your screen. Now this doesn't have any audio. This is just screencasting. And it's super quick and it's super easy to use and great for showing clients or students or, you know, family or friends how to do something real quick. And then you can even save it as a GIF, which comes in handy for things like social media and emails and etc. So you just save it, and then when you're ready to share it with somebody, you just send them the link, and then that's it. All right, so now you know all of the different ways that you can record your screen using your Mac or your PC if you're using a web tool. But Do you have to use all of those? No. I highly suggest just using the ones that make the most sense for you and your budget. Be sure to click the link so that you can enroll in my free course, Simplify Your Biz Tools. If you enjoyed the video, give me a like, subscribe, and share it with your friends. So, what tools do you use to record your screen? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. There are like 5 ways that you can do it. 5, not 10. 5 ways that you can do it. Ben, I'm good. What's this hair? I don't know why that's always so difficult. I want to know from you. So give me a thumbs up. Hit the like button. All right, I really need to work on that.